What's up, Laker fans? Welcome to part two of my series on the new Laker offense. Today we're going to cover Motion Week. The Lakers switched to Motion Week at the end of February last season, so I'm including some clips from those games. I'm also including clips of the San Antonio Spurs, who run Motion Week as well as anyone in the NBA. Let's start out by looking at how the motion of Motion Week actually works. The action starts with an initial pass to the wing, as you see here. After Clarkson makes that pass, he's going to loop around to the weak side wing. As Clarkson's making this cut, the ball is passed from the wing to the big at the top of the key, who's Julius Randle in this case. As that's happening, Anthony Brown is leaving the spot that Clarkson is going to. Brown is going to set a cross screen on Roy Hibbert's man in order to get Hibbert a post up. Randle then passes the ball back to Clarkson so he can make that post entry pass. Now let's watch it again in real time. Initial pass to the wing, up top, Clarkson loops around, Anthony Brown cross screen, back to Clarkson, then a Roy Hibbert post-up. Let's watch another one. Russell makes the initial pass to Anthony Brown, and then he's going to loop around to where Ingram is right now. Meanwhile, Ingram's going to set a cross screen on Zubac's man. Again in real time, initial pass to the wing, Russell loops around, pass up top to Nance, back to Russell, Ingram cross screen for Zubac, post up. Now we're going to take the same action and add one thing to the end. Russell makes the initial pass to Clarkson, then the ball gets passed up top to Randle as Russell loops around to the weak side wing. As this is happening, Anthony Brown is leaving the spot that Russell is going to set a cross screen on Roy Hibbert's man, even though Hibbert's slow getting up court. The ball is rotated back to Russell, right as Brown is setting that cross screen. Now here's the next part. Brown does what's called a zipper cut, a cut right up the middle of the court after he sets that cross screen for him. The goal is to get him an open jumper right here. To facilitate that, Randle sets a down screen on Brown's man. So in real time, it's the initial pass from Russell to the wing, then back up top to Randle as Russell loops around, cross screen from Brown, then a zipper cut from Brown as Randle downscreens for him. Here's the Spurs running the same action. Parker makes the initial pass, then cuts to the weak side wing. As the ball is rotated up top, you have a cross screen being set for the big. Then the man who set that cross screen makes a zipper cut, getting a downscreen for an open three. In real time, it's the initial pass to the wing, Parker loops around, pass up top while the cross screen happens, zipper cut, open three. Now let's focus on how well the Lakers executed this with three main points of emphasis. First, how well the wing cross screens for the big. Second, how well the big uses that screen. And third, where the guard who loops around catches the return pass. Ideally, he catches that around the free throw line extended, but as you can see here, Russell is pushed well beyond that. On the cross screen, Ingram's screening angle forces Zubac's man to take a wide angle. While Ingram doesn't make contact here, he still creates separation for Zubac. Zubac also reads the screen correctly, going low side when his defender goes over. You basically want to do the opposite of what your defender is doing. So when Zubac gets to this point, he's open because his defender hasn't recovered yet. The problem is that since Russell is pushed so far out, he doesn't have the passing angle to get the ball to Zubac. This is a missed opportunity and results in a post catch 10 feet from the basket. Now let's watch the Spurs on the same play. Parker catches the ball on the free throw line extended. While that catch is happening, the cross screen's being set. Duncan reads that his defender's going high side, so he goes low side, same as Zubac. But the difference is that Parker is in position to deliver this pass. So why are the Laker guards being pushed out so far beyond the free throw line extended? The reason it happened a lot last year is that they had very little counter action. Mike Conley knows that the Lakers are running Motion Week, so he's going to play ball denial on Clarkson to prevent the return pass from happening. As this is happening, Anthony Brown sets a decent cross screen for Hibbert, but Hibbert misuses it. Hibbert doesn't set up the screen by faking one way and going another, and Brown's screening angle indicates that Hibbert should go over the top. Hibbert goes low side instead. Conley's ball denial has pushed Clarkson's catch 30 feet from the hoop, and Hibbert didn't get any separation from his man because he didn't use the screen correctly. And it took so long to get the ball to Clarkson that Anthony Brown couldn't zipper cut because he would have run into Randall. So he ends up just drifting aimlessly into the corner. This results in a post-up for Roy Hibbert with no action going on around him, which isn't a good idea. Watch it in real time and see how long Julius Randle has the ball waiting to get the ball back to Clarkson. And that's not Randall's fault. So why don't teams play denial like this on the Spurs? It's because when they do, the Spurs have a counter for it. This is an example of a deep cut by Parker on this play, as was Clarkson on the last. Here, Tony Parker's man goes high side to play denial on the return pass, so Parker just back cuts him. When the return pass is denied here, it automatically flows into a dribble handoff going the other way. On this one, Manu's defender goes high side to deny the return pass after Manu makes a deep cut. So Manu uses that against him and changes direction, receiving a screen from the big who was supposed to receive the cross screen. Counters like this can either be a play call by the coaching staff or a read by the players on the court. While I didn't expect it in Summer League, the Lakers will have to learn how to apply these counters in order to run Motion Week effectively. This was the best Motion Week set the Lakers had during the summer, albeit with the backups. You have a great cross screen here and the big runs his man right into it. After making the cross screen, Tony Raggi makes a hard zipper cut and Jarvis Varnado makes excellent contact on the screen. The end result is a wide open three. On this one, Anthony Brown sets a good cross screen, but Randall doesn't cut particularly hard off of it. One of the variations of a zipper cut is the curl off of the down screen, and this is an example of a time where you should do that. Brown's defender is trailing right behind him and clearly on the left side of Hibbert's screen, so Brown should curl this toward the basket. But Brown takes too wide of an angle, which makes him go side to side rather than toward the basket. As a result, the advantage of the curl is eliminated. Contrast that to this play. You got Patty Mills setting the cross screen here, and then he goes to make the zipper cut. His defender's trailing him just as Brown's was, but he curls toward the basket and collapses the defense. This is the sort of action that all of our good shooters should be effective at. Here are a couple of zipper cut counters. You can fake the cross screen and go directly into the zipper cut like we see here. Or if you have a big who can shoot, he can fake like he's going to use the cross screen and do the zipper cut himself. Pick and rolls out of Motion Week are the last action I'm going to cover here. This is another place where it's detrimental for the guard to catch the return pass so far away. Russell receives this pass 35 feet from the basket and nowhere near the wing. As this is happening, the cross screen is being set in the paint. Fall makes the correct read by going high side as his defender goes low side to get around the screen. Russell's given up his dribble to get within about 30 feet of the basket and Fall sets a good screen. Despite being well out of position and running this pick and roll, they actually had a good look for Fall, but Russell missed. The goal here is to get a side pick and roll that isn't iced, because that's hard for the help defense. They got that, but Russell missed the read. Similar play here. Wilson sets a cross screen for Zubats, and Zubats makes the correct read by going over. Munford gives up his dribble a little early, but they still get that side pick and roll that isn't iced. He ends up drawing free throws with options all around. One thing that I want to emphasize is the value of keeping your dribble alive. In most cases, you want the guard who caught the ball on the return pass to wait until the pick comes. Here you see Munford give it up before August is in position, although August rescreens and they create an open look. I'd like to see the Laker guards get better at holding onto the ball and waiting for the screen to come before giving up their dribble. Watch how Parker does it. On this one, you'll see Russell leave too early after Ingram sets a nice cross screen to free up Zubats. One thing we did a lot of last year that drove me crazy was running pick and rolls right into congestion. One pick and roll variation that they ran off of Motion Week was screening with the top guy. That's Randall in this case. He makes the return pass to Russell and immediately goes into a pick and roll. The problem with that is that the cross screen is happening as the pick and roll is happening. Russell turns the corner off of this pick and roll and there are five guys in the paint waiting for him. This video only scratches the surface on what you can do out of Motion Week, but I hope it gives you an idea of what to look for early on. I'll catch you guys next time in part 3 when I cover drag screens and 45s.